esophageal atresia, or EA, is a condition in which the esophagus is not connected to itself when a child is born. When the gap between the two ends of the esophagus is too far apart, it is called long gap EA. When possible, the best treatment option for a long gap EA is to try to preserve the esophagus. That's why we recommend the Foker process whenever the ends are too far apart to put together at the first attempt. This technique aims to close the gap by growing the esophagus. In the Foker process, a surgeon makes a small incision in your child's back, and then places a series of sutures, or stitches, on the upper and lower ends of their esophagus. These stitches connect the ends to a traction system that is on the outside of your child's body. Over the course of about 1 to 3 weeks, your child's clinician will increase the tension on the sutures bit by bit. This causes each end of the esophagus to grow about 1 to 2 millimeters each day, just like a muscle grows when you exercise it. As a result, the esophagus will grow enough for your child's surgeon to attach the two ends. During this process, your baby will need to be motionless. That's because excessive motion might break or pull out the sutures. They will stay in the intensive care unit on a ventilator, a breathing machine, and will be given medication to help them stay still and comfortable. Once the esophagus has grown to the desired length, the surgeon will remove the sutures and sew together the two ends of the esophagus. Almost all of the patients treated with this method to date are able to eat and swallow, and the new esophagus typically looks and works like one that developed normally. Since 2009, Boston Children's surgeons have been the pioneers and strongest proponents of the Foker process. As a result, families from all over the world come to us for our expertise in this technique. Recently, Boston Children's surgeons have developed a new minimally invasive approach to the Foker process that does not require the child to be asleep and still while the esophagus is growing on traction. I'll tell you more about that in our next and final video.